TESOL jobs in Spain. General information. There is such a tremendous amount of marked regional diversity in Spain that one is almost dealing with a mini-continent. Life on the costas, Spain's huge coastline, differs greatly from that in the big cities, which in turn differs from life in the thousands of picturesque rural villages, which is again different from the ski slopes of Andora or Granada. Dispirit locations and circumstances are united in a profound love of life, sometimes combined with a slight disdain for work. Spaniards work to live, they do not live to work. Hence it is very easy to get swept up in a seemingly constant round of fiestas and festivals, music and dancing, eating well and drinking well, being all part of pursuing the good life in the best of all possible worlds. Despite the fact that practically nothing runs on time, few who have lived in Spain for a spell would disagree with the idea that, in terms of quality of life, Spain is a world leader. It's a big country with climate to suit all tastes. Very hot in the south with temperatures getting into the 40s, cool in the north, and snowbound in the Pyrenees. The official language is Spanish, though Catalan, Basque, and Gallego are the official languages in these autonomies. English is not widely spoken outside of the principal tourist areas on the costas. The population is 42 million, and whilst there is plenty of hustle and bustle in the big cities, the rural areas leave one with the impression that nobody has been there for years. Prospects for English teachers have long been good in Spain, with language schools catering to the needs of high school and university students seeking to shore up the tuition they get at their main place of study. However, Spain underwent a huge period of economic growth in the late 20th century and continues to be Western Europe's fastest growing economy. This has meant that more and more employers are requiring English skills from prospective employees, and business-specific academies have sprang up to meet the needs of multinationals seeking to improve the language skills of their employees. Despite the plenitude of opportunities, it should be borne in mind that pay in the expense of big cities is not dissimilar to that in the rural areas, where it is much cheaper to live. Popular destinations. Where not to go. The big cities of the south, such as Seville and Cadiz, offer a dazzling array of Moorish and medieval architecture, often in the same building, along with flamenco music and dance. The costas range from Benidorm, where you will find it difficult to escape the idea that England has somehow been towed into the Mediterranean, to the beautiful and unspoiled Costa de la Luz, Coast of Light, where you will have trouble finding people who speak English. There are many fabulous places that fall somewhere in between. Barcelona, in Catalonia, prides itself on its cosmopolitan countenance and has fabulous architecture, not least by Gaudi, local boy made good. Madrid has all that you would expect in any European capital city. Art and architecture abound in an air of cool sophistication. In Galicia, you are greeted by mountains and mile after mile of moody, haunting forest. Just about anywhere in Spain you can expect fabulous food and drink, dancing and music, and a party atmosphere that goes on long into the night. A certain amount of stamina is required, and you have to get used to the idea of going out at 10 or 11 at night and having your last drink and your last tapas surrounded by bus drivers and other workers about to start their day. Teaching. Anyone wishing to teach in a state or private school can expect to have a degree, a postgraduate certificate in education and a TESOL qualification, though you should check with your prospective employer first. Though 2 years of teaching experience is not a requisite. With language institutes or academias, you can, in the main, expect to find yourself teaching high school or university students, sometimes in the same class. Specialist business schools aim to cater to the needs of large multinationals, and with these any sort of business background is an advantage. Enthusiasm for English amongst the general population is nowhere near as high, for example, as it is in Germany or Holland, meaning both the market is not as broad, and the motivation of those being taught is not quite as great. However, this is changing, and there is a move afoot to bring English in earlier in the school curriculum. In the main, you will find yourself teaching students of varying ability, sometimes in the same class. However, a great deal of the Spanish education goes into learning Spanish grammar. So with grammar, a Spaniard will tend to know what they are talking about. Preparation of classes is key to maintaining the impression that you do too. Getting a job. When trying to get work in advance, it is useful to contact the British Council in Madrid. They will be able to advise you as to where in Spain the British Council has offices. In general, they keep a list of language schools, both private and state. In addition to that, the online yellow pages should be searched using the term Academias de Idiomas. If in the UK, then consult The Guardian on Tuesdays and other academic press, since it is not unusual to find Spanish positions advertised in the English press. With this said, the vast majority of positions are filled on the spot, and, as ever in Spain, right at the last minute. The corollary to this is that timing is a very important issue. Most language schools shut for the summer, so September is a really good time to arrive and look for work. In addition to that, there is often a spike of recruitment activity in January when teachers fail to return to work. Month to month, September to June, there are constantly opportunities coming up, but in the summer you are best off doing what everybody else does and head down to the beach. It is a good idea, before setting off, to contact your local Spanish embassy to see what materials they have available. Most consulates have a one-page document entitled Teaching English in Spain, and the consulate in the UK has a list of institutes, though it may not be up to date. It is worth contacting the Federación Española de Centros de Enseñanza de Idiomas, which is an organization of the better, more established language schools. There is a recruitment agency, an Irish or British nationals with an undergraduate degree and a TESOL qualification may consider contacting English Education Services, Madrid. English language newspapers included the Metropolitan in Barcelona and in Madrid. Not to be ignored is the vote for Irish pubs that seems to have swept the nation. A good place to meet expats and to find out what is going on locally in the English language world. Visas and regulations. Some state schools are not prepared to go through the difficult process of hiring native English-speaking teachers from outside of Europe. However, in some cases it is easier to place teachers from the US than from other countries, such as Australia and New Zealand. Non-EU citizens should check with the Spanish consulate in their native country to look for language exchange programs, etc. Americans may wish to contact InterExchange of New York, who run an exchange program. One of the complications is the reciprocal social security system that exists within the EU. High schools are required to register their staff for a social security card and also pay part of their contributions, which means that they may not willing to take on anybody who is ineligible. It is always best to check with the school first. Most individuals working for institutes are self-employed or freelance. Therefore, they are responsible for paying their own tax and social security. New arrivals are required to register with the police, organize a bank account into which their wages will be paid, and get a tax number from their local tax office. It is important to be aware that private academies can be a little fly-by-night and may not be up to the mark in terms of paying your contributions or any of the other things that they are legally required to do. The most important thing is to ensure that you are adequately covered against accident or injury if you are non-EU. TESOL jobs in Spain. At ITTT, we offer our popular TESOL certification courses in four exciting locations across Spain. If you are thinking about becoming an English language teacher, why not become internationally certified at one of our training centers in Barcelona, Seville, Malaga, or Granada? Spain has long been a top TESOL destination, and it is not hard to see why. The kingdom features beautiful natural scenery, delicious local food, and countless historic sites, such as castles and palaces. A vibrant nightlife is also part of Spanish culture, including tapas, dancing, and great music. Whichever location you choose, you are guaranteed a fun time during your stay in Spain. TESOL Spain. All our TESOL courses are internationally recognized, meaning you are able to work virtually anywhere in the world after successful completion. Many of our TESOL graduates fall in love with the country and decide to stay in Spain, while others move on to neighboring European countries or countries across Asia, South America and the Middle East, where the demand for English teachers is also high. With our courses in Spain being offered throughout the year, you are able to join a course each month at one of our incredible locations. Upon completion of the course, you will also benefit from our extensive job support, helping you to find a job in Spain, around Europe or anywhere else in the world. With a TESOL certification in hand, you can be sure to secure your dream job. TESOL course in Spain's favorite city. Barcelona is one of the most visited cities in Spain. No wonder, as it features historic landmarks, astonishing architecture and a fascinating local culture that is very distinct from the rest of the country. One of the many reasons why Barcelona is the ideal TESOL destination is its incredible nightlife, with countless restaurants, pubs and bars open through the night serving local specialties. The famous streets of Las Ramblas, La Placa Catalunya, and El Portal de l'Angel will transform you back in time and let you go crazy shopping for souvenirs. Conveniently situated on the coast, Barcelona is also home to some of the finest beaches in Spain, giving you one more reason to love this city. On the weekends, you can even explore other parts of Spain, as Barcelona is a major transportation hub with a train network leading all over Europe. TESOL course in Spain's flamenco capital. Seville is located in the region of Andalusia in the south of Spain. The city is over 2,000 years old and is full of beautiful architecture and is also a major center for the arts. However, what the city is probably most famous for is dancing. It is here where the world-famous flamenco dance style originated. Still today, the city holds festivals where dancers fill the streets and impress locals and visitors alike with their skills. Situated by the Guadalquivir River, you get to take long walks or even have a picnic along the river after class. If you decide to spend a month in Seville and train to become an English language teacher, you will make unforgettable memories living in one of the most iconic cities in Spain. TESOL course in Granada. The entire city of Granada looks like it came straight out of a painting, with Moorish-style houses with terracotta roofs in front of marvelous mountain scenery. In fact, the entire city was declared a UNESCO World Heritage Site due to its unique charm. The old Arabic quarter is well worth exploring, with water fountains, cobblestone alleys and stunning old buildings. When in Granada, you will feel like you have traveled back in time to a medieval paradise, as the province of Andalusia is famous for its unique architecture and castles. TESOL course in Malaga. Malaga is truly one of the most vibrant cities in Spain. Overlooking the Costa del Sol, the city is rich in sandy beaches and beautiful ocean water. If this sounds like a place you would enjoy living in for a month, come to our Malaga Training Center, and we will teach you all you need to know to become an English language teacher. On top of that, Malaga has a large number of language schools that are always looking for qualified teachers. For those already in the city, it is rarely a problem finding a suitable teaching position. Should you not want to stay in Malaga, you can easily find employment throughout Europe or virtually anywhere else in the world with our internationally recognized TESOL certificate.